before I started digging in that other bag. Here you go. No problem.
If you need to fix something in space that wasn't designed to be fixed, it's going to take all the experience you can get. With that in mind, when the International Space Station's Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer, or AMS, needed repairs, NASA's Johnson Space Center and Goddard Space Flight Center used their joint expertise to make it happen. At Goddard, that expertise resides in NASA's Exploration and In-Space Services Division, or NExIS, which evolved from the office that was responsible for the Hubble Space Telescope servicing missions. Key to these missions was the development of specialized tools. While you've probably heard of Hubble, you may not be as familiar with AMS, so let's start there. Designed for a 3-year mission of sifting through cosmic ray particles, AMS has been looking for signs of dark matter from its position on station since 2011. Hundreds of researchers have used the data collected to investigate the source of the mysterious substance to help us better understand the origins of the universe. To continue this important data collection, AMS needed an upgrade due to general wear and tear from the harsh environment of space, specifically a new cooling system. A repair could extend its life beyond what was originally planned. Sounds easy enough, right? In fact, due to the instrument's complexity and the fact that it was not designed to be repaired, even gaining access to the system to replace it was difficult. AMS's design did not incorporate the kinds of interfaces that make spacewalks easier, or have the ability to be serviced with traditional multi-purpose tools. And so, over the course of 4 years, NASA got to work designing and developing some of the most complex spacewalks since the Hubble servicing missions in the 90s and early 2000s to fix AMS.
The AMS tools themselves were unique. They were built specifically for this task, a task that was never intended to be performed on a spacewalk. And so that required a lot of thinking about how we were going to get inside so that we could access the tubes that we needed to cut into and then install the new thermal control system, but also how to put handling aids on it so that we had a place to attach our tethers, to attach our foot restraints, to have handholds, have a place to attach equipment that we needed out there.
NASA developed 20 specialized tools to make the job possible, and on November 15, 2019, astronauts Andrew Morgan and Luca Parmitano got to work. On this first spacewalk, astronauts needed to get access. By design, 5 of the tools could be seen floating off into space, attached to the debris shield that was removed to give the astronauts access to the heart of AMS.
The debris shield handling aid was one of the first tools that Luca installed on the EVA, and this gave us a handhold to install on the debris shield to work from, but also a handle for me to hold on to ultimately when we jettisoned it overboard to the aft side of the ISS, which was a lot of fun to do.
The astronauts continued with 3 more spacewalks over the next 2 months using all of the specially designed tools. One such tool was the tube cutting guide, which was a direct result of multiple practice sessions at Johnson Space Center facilities like the Neutral Buoyancy Lab. While practicing, astronauts communicated the need for a way to identify and verify the correct tubes to cut, since they all look the same to the astronauts' eyes within the spacesuit.
After we had removed the debris shield and the VSB cover, now we have the tubes exposed, and we actually had to cut into those tubes in order to pull out the correct ones to connect with the new thermal control system, the new pump. In order to do that, we had to be very sure of the tubes that we were cutting. These ingenious tube cutting guides installed over the top of the tubes and made sure that we knew and we were communicating correctly with the ground team to make sure that we were cutting the correct tube at the right time.
In January 2020, Luca Parmitano and Drew Morgan completed the 4th and final spacewalk to repair AMS. Because of their work and the ingenuity of tool designers and engineers, the instrument is now back in commission and able to continue to collect data about the origins of our universe for years to come.
People from Goddard and JSC spend a lot of time developing these tools with their knowledge and the support of astronauts like Chris Cassidy. And we are very thankful that we were privileged to use those tools and to put them to very successful use. Thank you very much.